Hi guys, my name is Chubby. Today I'm going to show you how to solo Highlord Omok in Lower Blackrock Spire to get your best in slot caster pants, the Sky Shroud Leggings. I'm going to showcase this on my Elemental Shaman, who has probably the hardest time doing this out of all the casters. First off, you have to kill these two Scar Shield Legionnaires. I found the best way to do so is to not use Chain Lightning and instead use Stoneclaw Totem so the second mob is distracted for a few seconds. I was really lucky with crits, so I managed to kill both at the same time, but usually I kill one and then run out of the dungeon to reset the second one. Be careful, as they can interrupt you. Now just wait here until the patrol shows up and then jump down and jump with this angle into the corridor. This is a very precise jump. If you pull the group to the right, put down Earthbind Totem and continue running. If this wolf is level 53, you can run past it without aggroing the group. If it's a higher level, put down a Stoneclaw Totem the moment you aggro them and pray not to get rooted by the Scar Shield Raiders. Now, I had the best case scenario and didn't aggro anything, but if you do, come up here and let's pause for a sec because this place is important. The first reason that this is important is that up here is a safe space. Everything you aggroed will eventually reset and you can move on. The second reason is that NPC you see on the right, as that guy gives you the quest for the upper Blackrock Spire key. The third reason is you can use this place to jump over to the ogre area with a swiftness potion and a slow fall effect. I won't show that in this run, but I will upload a run on my mage where I do that jump. The jump is fast, but risky. If you jump wrong, you will die. So now let's continue the regular way. It's longer but safer, and you have to use a lesser invisibility potion and a regular invisibility potion. Jump up here and pop the lesser invis potion. The potion will expire around this bridge, and you can now carefully jump onto the rope of the bridge and then towards the torch. Here we have to wait 2 minutes for the potion cooldown. Luckily, the lesser invis potions and the regular invis potions don't share their 10 minute cooldown. Now after the 2 minutes, we can pop the invis potion and just walk all the way into the ogre area. All this was the easy part, and now starts the hard part, killing all the ogres. The first pack is a bit tricky as you have to juggle them in this tunnel by jumping up and down this ledge, so you don't aggro the ones at the entrance of the tunnel. To consistently pull this jump off requires a bit of practice. On your first few runs you will probably die, like I do here. Also, always try to kill the ogre magi first as they have tendency to desync from the group. Now, after killing this first pack, we can take a little breather and we can also reset them now if we screw up. I will show you in a minute how. Next, we kill the 3 ogres that are at the tunnel entrance, so we can use more than just the tunnel to kill them. On a side note, never slow these mobs unless it's the last one of any given pack or an ogre mystic. Now, this is the toughest group aside from the boss group. This pack always consists of 1 melee ogre, 1 ogre magi and 1 ogre mystic. The mystics can make this run a real headache, as they cast healing spells whenever an ogre within range drops below 50% health. The best way to deal with them is to either desync them from the group using slows on the mystic, or nuke them down while interrupting and purging their heals. If you are not a shaman, just CC them and it becomes a lot easier, for example a mage can cheat them. I managed to desync the mystic from the rest, but now it's a race against the clock to kill the 2 other ogres before the mystic kills me. As you see, desyncing the group can become dangerous really quickly. After killing the 2 guys, I now reset the mystic by jumping up on the ledge on the other side. A solo mystic is no problem for a shaman, just Earthshock his healing wave and purge his rejuvenation. The next few groups are easy, so let's talk a bit about other classes. I did this on my old mage, who has a lot less gear and a shitty PvP spec, and it was a lot easier thanks to sheep. Oh, and mages have a lot more mana regeneration as well. Now, warlocks should have no issue doing this, as they can freely fear after killing the first 2 packs and keep the mystics from healing that way. Also, dots are super good here. Shadow priests are probably the easiest, as I can walk past all the mob groups in the beginning with mind soothe, and mind control is basically cheating in these situations. I guess Moonkings could have an even harder time compared to Shamans here, but who plays Moonkings, am I right? High Lord Omok has always the same two adds, one Ogre Magi and one Ogre Mystic. In my case, I managed to desync the Mystic a little, and I got lucky as he started healing himself very close to the door, so I could Urshock him in time and kill him shortly after. After killing the Magi, I wanted to reset Omok, but this is not needed. Now I'm going to show you how not to fight Omok. Never ever fight him in the tunnel, or this can happen. Now after spending another 2 Invis potions, I'm back here and will show you how to kill him properly. Wait until he comes all the way around and kill him that way. If you get knocked back at this position, you won't fall down. There's not much to talk about, just rinse and repeat. Don't forget to heal yourself every now and then and you should be fine. And that's Omok down, and of course the leggings didn't drop. You can continue using this ledge to clear the entire troll area, including Woon and Voshka Chin. I hope this little guide helped you. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.